Hey, I'm Gaur, and welcome back. This time, we're having a look at my new Corrector DCTL, which, as the name suggests, is for correcting shot-to-shot. I've tried to bring together all of the different tools I tend to use when correcting and bring them into a single tool, because sometimes I like to use things in linear, sometimes in, well, my working space being DaVinci Intermediate, and there are some things that require different nodes, and then some cannot be done with the default tools in Resolve, so essentially, I've just tried to bring everything together into one place, plus add some utilities like white balance checking, middle grey checking, and the like. So, enough blabbering, let's head to Resolve. So I've set up this test project for you, with the Arizabella test image, and node-based color management, going from Ari White Gamut 3, Log C 3, to DaVinci White Gamut Intermediate, that being my working space, and at the end, going from there to Rec 709, Gamma 2-4, that being my reference monitor's color space. Now, where would you put the Corrector DCTL is up to you. If you like to work in the camera's native space, you can do that. Just select the camera's color space. But in this case, I'll be working in DaVinci Intermediate. Now, before we actually get to correcting the shots, I'd recommend setting up a fixed node tree with this tool, because it has a lot of things you can customize. For all the different operations, you can actually use different underlying math. For example, exposure can be either linear gain or offset. Flare can be linear offset or lift, contrast, S-curve or linear. Balancing can be linear gain or offset. Saturation can be subtractive, gamma or gain. And finally, you can choose the working transfer function that the tools working in linear can use. In addition, you can choose between contrast preserving saturation or not, and balancing preserving luminance or not. And in addition, if you feel like the temp and tint sliders don't quite align with what you prefer, you can tweak that with the balance vector. And now with setup out of the way, let's try and correct this shot. First, I personally like to set exposure, hence why it's the first slider. And if you happen to have a color checker in your shot, as we do, you can also use the middle gray checker. When I turn it on, some red spots appear on the image, though we're not interested in them on her shirt, but in getting them to align with the middle gray patch, that being the third gray patch from the bottom. So to do that, let's start moving the exposure, and at some point it turns red to indicate that this now aligns with middle grey. Though of course, there's no such thing as correct exposure, as it depends on the contents of the shot and scene. Next, if the shot is facing problems with flare, in the case that a light or the sun is shining on the lens, you can use the flare slider to compensate for that, so in this case, we don't need it. Following that, we can work on our contrast either by using fill, which is exposure underneath middle grey to simulate changing to fill light, or if you prefer it, you can use the contrast slider, which is pivoted on middle grey. And once we're happy with our exposure and contrast, we can move on to white balance. For that, I have provided temp and tint sliders, though these are different from what you may be used to, as they work with the operations you have selected, linear gain or offset, that is different from the built-in temp and tint sliders, both in Resolve and in cameras. Now once again, as with exposure, I also have provided a checker for white balance, which just highlights everything that is neutral. We can see that only a single patch seems to be neutral, so let's play around with temp and tint to find a good middle ground where most of the patches are neutral. There we go, I think this is pretty good. And in addition, if you don't have anything neutral in the scene, you can also use the skin checker that highlights anything on the skin tone line. And once again, you can tweak this vector as we face a lot of different skin tones. Finally, after setting exposure, contrast and white balance, we have the saturation slider to finish things off. Well, there you go. If you like what you saw but would like to test it out yourself, you can get the demo pack, so same thing, just with a watermark. And if you don't know how to install DCTools, then there's a video for that. I'm Gold, and see you next time.